1992, and it rewired my brain. And since then, that's really been the lens through which I've seen the world. And after that, as Andy said, I used to do cartoons for the Permaculture magazine. This was one of my favourite that I found the other day. Those of you who do dry lands permaculture need to understand the sort of gelatinous tide that engulfs us temperate permaculturists in this country in terms of slugs, a rich vein of humour. So I did my diploma in 96. I taught permaculture, set up the first two-year permaculture design course in the world in Ireland in Kinsale College, and had a great time and did lots of that kind of stuff. And then in 2004, David Holmgren's book came out and rewired my brain again. Because it said, basically, we need to scale this stuff up really, really fast. And so really, since then, my kind of driving question has really been, how do we scale this stuff up? How do we take those design principles that are so awesome and fantastic, and that, as Jeff said, are the foundation of a sustainable world, a beautiful, abundant, nourishing world, how do we scale that stuff up? And so for me, transition was really based around the idea of a Trojan horse, in effect. I read this and I was like, right, come on then, let's sort this out. And looking around then in 2004 at the permaculture of people around me at the time, people often seemed quite happy in a kind of a niche, in a kind of a community, as you said, Kathy, where people were kind of talking the same language, and it didn't feel, we needed some way of scaling this up. I thought, what would it look like if we could have a Trojan horse that we could put permaculture principles in? I was wondering what that guy's thinking, looking out the horse, they're thinking, what, me, on my own? I thought other people were coming up and being with me too. But actually, how do we put those principles in there, other stuff as well, so that it can just be wheeled past everybody without needing to get the flip chart out and draw the arrows and the greenhouses and the chickens? They could just go, oh, it's transition, and in it goes. And that was really what informed it. So for me, I did my permaculture diploma presentation in 1996. So today, having sort of been away, or not so involved in permaculture for a while, this kind of feels like a sort of 19 years later diploma session update. So I feel like I want to sort of just sort of share some of the stuff that I've been involved with since then, which is based around that question of how do we scale this stuff up.